So good morning, everyone. My name is Leandro. Here I'm going to present this project that I did some months ago. This is an optimization of two echelon vehicle route problem with pickup and delivery. So this project is more related in humanitarian logistics. So imagine here we have a disaster situation. So some health agencies should provide an effective system of drug management. So we have to deliver some drugs in the disaster areas in order to ensure the efficient, cost-effective, and rational use of the drugs, because we have to deliver this drug to the people in emergency situation. By doing this, we are trying to prevent and reduce the excess of mortality and also morbidity. And then by doing this, we are trying to promote a return to normalcy when a disaster is occurred. So how can you provide in this context an effective distribution of the drugs and pharmaceuticals in primary health in the disaster situation? In this context, you have to deliver some urgently needed items, for instance, drugs, medicines, or blood, or defibrillators, whatever. And you have to deliver this in the affected areas after disasters occur. And you have to do this in a really fast way because the people is waiting for the health treatment. So we have to take decisions in a really fast way. So just to illustrate here, this problem, this specific problem, we have a central depot and we have some chemical and natural products. And we have to deliver this kind of products to some pharmacies. So these pharmacies produce some medicines using these products. And then we have to deliver to the emergency locations that is associated with emergency staff. So we do this delivery by using drones in this specific research, because when you have a disaster, we cannot use like conventional cargo vehicles because the roads might be destroyed. So we have to do this by using drones. So here, just to illustrate, it is a solution for this problem, a kind of solution, in which we have here a central depot, this is the zero one. And imagine this first route here in which we go to the pharmacy one to pick up the drugs and deliver some natural products. And then we go to the remaining points that are the first aid locations, which require the drugs from the pharmacies. So the objective here when solving this problem is to define the optimal sequence of first aid locations that we have to deliver the drugs. And we do this by using the drones that I just told you. So how can you find a solution for this problem in a really efficient way, in a really fast way? So we use in my research group, we always implement some fast, efficient, and simple algorithms. These algorithms are some sequence of smart decisions that we have to do to meet some goal. So in this case, our goal here is to minimize the transportation time for delivering these drugs in the disaster areas. So we do this kind of algorithms here. In this specific project, we have an external collaboration. So we have the professor, Dr. Patrick Hirsch. He is from the University of Natural Resources and Life Sciences in Vienna. I did my research stay there with him, solving this problem. So he's an expert in healthcare logistics and humanitarian logistics. So he's an essential key in this project because he knows how to model the problem in the context of humanitarian logistics. And from the methodological part, point of view, we have my director here at UOC, the professor Dr. Angel Juan, and he's a specialist in simulation and optimization algorithms. So he's more in the side of the methodological part. And that's me, who is learning from both sides, from the humanitarian part and from the optimization part. So this is very interesting for my thesis, because I work with this kind of problems, transportation problems. So here, there are some results that we were able to find using this methodology. So we were able to optimize the drug delivery system if we compare with some past research. In this specific case, we have an instance case in which we decrease the delivery time up to 30% of the time. So at the before, they were like, for some instance, they needed for 1,200 seconds to do the same sequence of nodes to deliver the drugs, and we could find a better solution for the same instance, the same problem, using 30% less delivery time. So returning to the topics that I told in the first slide, by doing this, we are ensuring the efficient, cost-effective, and rational use of the drugs in this kind of problems, in disaster situations, then preventing and reducing the excess of mortality, and trying to promote the return to normalcy. But if you think in a different way, since it is a transportation problem, when we are doing this, we are solving these problems with the objective to reduce transportation time, we are also reducing some gas emissions and air pollution. So we have here the environmental impact. If you think in urban centers, like Christina did her research, we are reducing some traffic congestion and reducing travel times. From the point of view of passengers, this is a nice contribution if you decrease the transportation time. And then we are trying to improve the life quality in general by doing this kind of research. And that's all. Thank you.